Today's forecast, sunny with clouds rolling in overnight, highs of 3,300 degrees, and a chance of silicate downpours? Hey there, fellow alien folk. Trace here for DNews. Obviously, we're not talking about Earth with that forecast from earlier. Instead, this is a possible weather forecast for distant hot Jupiter exoplanets, according to new observations by NASA's Kepler Space Telescope. We know the weather on other planets. Hot Jupiters are one of the most commonly found types of exoplanet. Like Jupiter, they're these massive gas giants, but they orbit crazy close to their stars, making them hot. Like really, really hot. As in, hot as a blowtorch hot. Because they are so close to their stars, hot Jupiters can orbit in less than 10 days. This means they become tidally locked with their star. One hemisphere is always facing the star in daylight, while the other is in constant night. We know this because of Kepler, not Johannes, the telescope named after him. Kepler was launched in 2009 and is an ace exoplanet hunter, even though it did break in 2013 and had a whole bunch of problems, but that's another story. When a planet passes in front of a star, it blocks a tiny amount of starlight, and the space telescope measures the amount and the timing of the dimming, and then can extrapolate the size and orbital period of the passing planet. We call this a transit. We have whole videos about it. But Kepler doesn't only detect the dimming starlight of exoplanets, it can also detect the light reflecting off those exoplanets and see the glow of their heated atmospheres. This adds a whole new dimension to the study of these extrasolar planets. Now we can get to know their weather. In a new study published recently in the Astrophysical Journal, astronomers were able to measure the amount of light being reflected from these hot Jupiters as they orbit their stars. Using the glow of the heated atmosphere, the paper details how many clouds there are, what chemicals those clouds are made of, and even where those clouds appear in the sky. Depending on the chemical composition of the exoplanet, the clouds could be in different places or have different colors, and for the hottest hot Jupiters, the atmosphere would glow like the embers of a fire after the hellish heating from the exoplanet's star. It's cool. You can see the full range on the different exoplanet temperatures and chemical compositions here. Space is awesome. The researchers could even tell what the rain on the planet would be like, which is definitely alien. For example, some of these exoplanets could drizzle silicate crystals. Basically, certain chemicals in the atmosphere condense and rain out just like water does here on our planet. Obviously, these planets are hundreds of light years away, so Kepler can't resolve tiny features like exoclouds directly. Instead, the researchers used Kepler's observations and combined that with models for weather and climate cycles that we used here on Earth. They then used that to create models for the possible weather conditions in alien atmospheres. A similar study published recently in the journal Nature Astronomy learned that another hot Jupiter has clouds of the mineral corundum. Corundum forms rubies and sapphires here on Earth. So could you imagine how beautiful those clouds would appear from orbit? Whoa. Look, understanding the weather on massive, hellishly hot worlds hundreds of light years away may not seem super important to you and me, but revealing the weather systems on these hot Jupiters adds another level of understanding about the rich diversity of alien atmospheres out there. And as astronomical techniques become more sophisticated, it seems likely that we will one day be able to study the weather systems on nearby Earth-sized exoplanets too, perhaps revealing just how habitable these places could be for alien life. I say again, space is awesome. Hot Jupiters sound pretty terrifying, but they're actually not the worst. To learn more about these crazy planets, check out our terrifying video on exoplanets here. But how do you think these space meteorologists fare in comparison to your local meteorologist? Tell us about it in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and thanks for watching.